So democracy has always been intertwined with technology. The ancient Greeks used a sorting machine to randomly choose people to serve in government. The printing press helped pave the way for modern democracy. Television changed democracy. So did the internet. The technologies of artificial intelligence will transform democracy yet again. Now, replacing people with computers isn't necessarily interesting. When an AI takes over a task, the task changes. In particular, there can be changes over four dimensions: speed, scale, scope, and sophistication. The problem with AIs trading stocks isn't that they're better than humans, it's that they're faster. But AIs are better at chess and Go because they use more sophisticated strategies. We're worried about AI-controlled social media accounts because they operate on a superhuman scale. And the scope of the current generation of chatbots is unlike anything we've seen before. It gets interesting when changes in degree become changes in kind. AI-run social media accounts change the nature of discourse online by changing what we think and changing what we think others think. It's these sort of changes in democracy that I want to examine. So I'm going to be largely optimistic about the technology. I'm not going to dwell on the details of how AI works. Much of what I'm talking about is still future science fiction, but not stupid science fiction. Where I'm going to be more realistic and nuanced is about the social implications of the technologies. What happens when the changes in degree become changes in kind? So to that end, I wanted to discuss four different areas where AI will affect democracy: law writing, lawyering, law enforcement, and adjudication. This is not an exhaustive list of how AI will affect democracy. This is just a flavor for what's coming. Let's start. One, AIs can write laws. A law is just a piece of text that a government agrees to adopt. And as with every other profession, policymakers will turn to AI to help them write and revise text. AI can take human-written laws and figure out what they actually mean. Lots of laws are recursive, referencing sentences and paragraphs from other laws. AI is already good at making sense of all that. This means that AI can craft better written and less contradictory law. AI will also be good at finding legal loopholes and at creating legal loopholes. AI will be able to assist lobbyists in suggesting carefully worded amendments. AI can also help figure out unintended consequences of policy changes by simulating how the change interacts with other laws and human behavior. AI will be able to write more complex law than humans can. This means there might be less need for administrative rulemaking because all the details can be written into the law by the AI. And that will change the balance of power between the legislative and executive branches of government. Today, the government agencies are the bureaucracy that spells out all the details. In the future, legislators can do that in the law itself if they want. Overall, these are probably good changes: better written law, better understanding of what a law actually means. The worry is that AI will give the most powerful groups more tools for propagating their interests. Two, AIs can be attorneys. Early attempts at having AIs write legal briefs didn't go well. Future AIs will be much better at writing legalese, and this will drastically reduce the cost of legal counsel. And there's every indication that AI will be able to do much of the routine work that lawyers do. So let's talk about what that means. Most obviously, it reduces the cost of legal advice and representation, giving it to people who currently can't afford it. A public defender with extra help from an AI is going to be a lot better than an overworked human public defender with no help. But if we assume that human plus AI beats AI only, then the rich get the combination and the poor are stuck with just the AI. AI will also result in more sophisticated legal arguments. Its ability to search all of the law to bolster its case will change the nature of precedent. AI will also change the meaning of a lawsuit. Right now, suing someone acts as a strong social signal because of the cost. If that cost drops to free, the signal will be lost, and orders of magnitude more lawsuits will be filed, which will overwhelm the court system and maybe force courts to start using AI technologies. Another effect could be gutting the profession. Lawyering is based on apprenticeship, but if most of the apprentice slots are filled by AIs, where do the newly minted lawyers go to get their training? And then where do the top human lawyers come from? So this might not happen, right? AI-assisted lawyers might result in more human lawyering. We just don't know yet. Three, AIs can enforce the law. In a sense, this is nothing new. Automated systems already act as law enforcement, speed trap cameras, breathalyzers. But AI can take this kind of thing much further, automatically identifying people who cheat on tax returns, identifying fraud on government service applications, auditing all government contracts, watching all of the traffic cameras and issuing citations. Here, the AI is performing a task that we don't have enough humans for and doing it faster and at scale. This has the obvious problem of false positives and bias, just like human law enforcers. But most importantly, it changes our relationship with the law. Everyone commits driving violations all the time. If we have a system of automatic enforcement, the way we all drive would change significantly. Now, many don't want this. In my home state of Massachusetts, it is illegal for the police to use speed and red light cameras. We underfund the IRS, even though auditing more of people is a profitable thing to do. AI can also help enforce regulations. This is also a problem of not enough humans, which means that lots of companies know they can ignore regulations with impunity. AI can change this by making enforcement more scalable and efficient. Imagine putting cameras in every slaughterhouse in the country looking for animal welfare violations. Corporations would likely respond with AI-automated compliance systems, which would give them even more ability to follow the letter of the law while ignoring the spirit. But this could be an enormous shift in the balance of power between government and corporations and help democratize democracy. Four, AI can adjudicate disputes, weighing evidence and making decisions, probably not in actual courtrooms, at least not anytime soon, but in other contexts. There are many areas of government where we don't have enough adjudicators. Benefits administration, for example. There, the cases are simple, but the backlog is enormous. AI has the potential to offer immediate justice to everyone. Maybe the AI does the first level of adjudication, and humans handle the hard cases and the appeals. Probably the first place we'll see this is in private contracts. Instead of two parties agreeing to binding arbitration to resolve disputes, they'll agree to binding arbitration by AI. This would significantly decrease the cost of arbitration, which would probably significantly increase the number of disputes. So imagine a world where dispute resolution is both cheap and fast. You and I are business partners, and if we have a disagreement, we can get a ruling in minutes. And we can do that as many times as we want, multiple times a day even. Will we lose the ability to disagree and then resolve our disagreements on our own? Or will this make it easier for us to be in a partnership and trust each other? So those are my four, and that's just a taste of what's coming. I don't think there's any part of democracy that AI won't touch. AI will help voters understand candidates and issues. AI will help elected officials understand their constituents. AI will change bureaucracy, making government more responsive. AI will help educate citizens and suggest candidates and issues they should support. AI will assist candidates writing speeches, fundraising emails, coordinating get-out-the-vote efforts. And there are a lot of moving parts to realizing any of this future. Adoption will depend on many factors. And this is where we come in. It's crucial for us to pay attention to how these systems are deployed in the world. Accuracy matters, but to different degrees. Candidate chatbot makes a mistake and it's an embarrassing gaffe. But if an AI algorithm helping you fill out your immigration paperwork makes a mistake, you could get deported. So trust is vital. In most of these examples, just the user has to trust the AI. But in others, AI law enforcement, all of society needs to trust that the AI is both accurate and fair. Security also matters. In a lot of these examples, the AI is being used in an adversarial environment. We have to think about people hacking these AIs, either to manipulate their output or just to spy on them. And power is really important. AI is a technology that increases power. What we want is for the power increase to be distributed and make society more equitable. The fear is that AI will further concentrate power by making the already powerful even more powerful. And finally, notice where AI either replaces humans versus where they enhance them. In most of these examples, the AI is doing the initial work, and then the humans are either verifying its accuracy or on hand to deal with the hard cases. AI will make human legislators more effective. It'll make initial enforcement decisions to be reviewed by humans. It'll replace human attorneys for some tasks and enhance them for others. It will completely replace human adjudicators in some instances. This is all important. We should prefer when AIs augment people and not replace them. This also improves reliability by keeping the humans in charge. The timeline for all of this is fuzzy. It depends on all these things and also the continually improving technologies of AI, which are hard to predict. But the tech is moving in this direction. I think this is all coming. And the examples I gave don't require any major changes in government to happen. They don't even need people to agree on anything. Individual legislators will use AI tools as soon as they are useful. Attorneys already are. We already have automatic law enforcement. And AI arbitration just has to be agreed upon by the two parties. This is how we're going to see AI creep into our democracy. Not from the top down, but from the bottom up. Again, watch where changes in degree result in changes in kind. The sophistication of AI lawmaking will mean more detailed laws, which will change the balance of power between the executive and legislative branches of government. The scale of AI lawyering means that litigation will become affordable to everyone, which will mean an explosion in the amount of litigation. The speed of AI adjudication means that contract disputes will get resolved much faster, which will change the nature of business and partnership. And the scope of AI enforcement means that some laws will become impossible to evade, which will change how the rich and powerful think about them. These are all changes that will matter in the long term. They'll affect how democracy works, just as past technologies have. But we don't live in the long term, we live in the now. And while we're thinking about the now, the short term, keep the following four things in mind. One, center equity. AI is good or bad, that's not the question to ask. We must ask whom it will help and whom it will hurt. Like all democratic processes, responsible use of AI should balance benefits and risks across all of society. Two, don't be afraid to use AI tools where they can help. Auditing government contracts, dealing with deluges of documents, inequity in enforcement, these are all areas where AI can make a big difference right now. Three, look both ways. Don't consider the effects of AI in one democratic system in isolation, because it's likely to be deployed by many different parties. AI might make it easier for lobbyists to insert loopholes in legislation, but it'll also make it easier for watchdog groups to find those loopholes. AI will make it easier to both enforce and evade regulations. And four, be responsive and adaptable. AI will fail, and its applications will sometimes be misguided, and the consequences of this will manifest much faster than the human-driven past. Government needs to be capable of switching tactics much more nimbly to get the best out of AI. AI will be one of humanity's most important inventions. What we don't know is if this is the moment we're inventing it, or if today's systems are yet more overhyped technologies. But these are uses that we're going to have to grapple with eventually. AI is fundamentally a power-enhancing technology. We need to ensure that it distributes power and doesn't further concentrate it. AI is coming for democracy. Whether those changes are a net positive or a net negative depends on us. Let's help tilt things to the positive. Thank you.